Good morning. Good morning, everybody. Happy St. Patrick's Day. I don't know about you, Father Kelly, but it feels like a crisp Irish day up here for me. On behalf of the city of Coral Springs, I'm John Hearn, the city attorney. On behalf of our commission, our staff, we want to welcome you all for this tremendous day. We are so excited to finally have this day to formally dedicate 94th Ave as Walter Skip Campbell Ave. Woo! Before we begin, I'm going to call up Father Kelly for the invocation in one moment. Father Kelly came to Coral Springs in 1985 when the Archdiocese formed St. Elizabeth Ann Seton. And I know I think we have some school board members here. The first masses were at Ramblewood Middle School. And Father Kelly has been serving this community, dedicated to this community for 37 years. He's done a tremendous amount for this community. Skip, a very faithful man, was a regular at Mass. Didn't always stay to the end, Father, but he was regular. And the Campbell Family Parish Church is St. Elizabeth's. And Father is a great, great friend of Skip. He's a great friend of mine. Father, come up here and enjoy the sunshine with me, would you? Invocation.
The 37 years have taken its toll. I am happy to be here this morning sharing this very special day and to be asked to start the procedures with our dedication, with the invocation. So I ask you to please bow your heads. Today, we celebrate the life of Walter Skip Campbell Jr. And we thank you, Lord, for that gift. We dedicate an avenue in his name, in respect and gratitude for his dedication and service. On this special morning of St. Patrick's Day, which Skip has such a great love and respect for, we ask you, Lord, to bless all of us present so that we can continue to work for the good of our people and to strive for peace and justice in our city, state, and world. And so we pray. May the road rise to meet us. May the wind be always at our back. May the sun shine warm upon our faces. The rains fall soft upon our fields. And until we meet again, may God hold us in the palm of his hand. And I'm sure that Skip's wish for us today is that we will have a song in our hearts, a smile on our lips, and nothing but joy at our fingertips. Amen.
Thank you, Father Kelly. If everyone could now stand, we're going to have the presentation of the colors, and I'm going to call Leo Perudominski up. He will then do the Pledge of Allegiance after that. This is Skip's youngest grandson. Thank you.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you to the Coral Springs Pipes and Drums and to Leo. Leo, your grandfather would be very proud of you. Everyone can sit down. So we had planned to do this exactly 2 years ago. The world had other plans for us, and we knew this was the perfect day to do it. We thank the Campbells for their patience, but here we are. It's 2 years of the day, actually, that we planned it. And we are so thankful for the entire Campbell family for being here. Lynn, God bless you. You know, we love you and your family. I want to recognize, in fact, as I was standing here looking out, I feel like Stephen in Braveheart. Stephen was the Irishman in Braveheart that could talk to God. He looked out and said, "This must be a fashionable event. It's drawn all the finest people." And some of those finest people are my Coral Springs Commission, my bosses. So let's get to them immediately. Mayor Scott Brook is here. Vice Mayor Josh Simmons. Commissioner Sean Serra. Commissioner Joy Carter. And Commissioner Nancy Matea. We also have a previous commission member, Vice Mayor and Commissioner Larry Vignola is here. As well as Lou Simagli. There you are, Lou. Larry and Commissioner Carter were very instrumental in having 94th Ave renamed, because those were the two that were in office at that time. Also joining is Representative Christine Hunchowski. Christine. I believe Dan Daly's legislative aide is here. I can tell you Dan Daly is in Ireland right now, and they're 5 hours ahead, so we're not going to be able to get in touch with them. But Dan Daly. District 8, I think Stephanie DeZorgine is here for him, and also Sarah Parasow, I believe. And Michael Udine is here, our county mayor. Michael, welcome. In addition, we have our tremendous city manager, Frank Babinick, is here. And some of the most dedicated staff you're going to find anywhere in our city staff. Welcome, everybody. And lastly, we want to welcome the firm of Krupnik Campbell, Malone, Boozer, Slama, and Hancock. I saw Clyde in the audience. I thought Hancock. That firm was founded by Skip and John Krupnik over 45 years ago. And we'll be hearing later from Kelly Hancock later in the program. So today, as Father Kelly says, the day we honor St. Patrick. It is a holiday that has evolved into a celebration of Irish culture and traditions. What a fitting day to honor a man who valued and so proudly celebrated his Irish roots. You have all received a shamrock pin to commemorate today's ceremony. I'm supposed to hold that up, I believe, but it's right here. There it is. We would love for you to wear that today and in future years on St. Patrick's Day in honor of Skip, if you would. This morning, you're going to hear from several speakers before we formally unveil Walter Skip Campbell Avenue, along with Skip's family representatives. You'll be reminded just how much his life and generosity impacted his family, our community, and the state of Florida. I, as a young lawyer, knew about Skip Campbell, and he became a mentor to me. My connection actually was John Krupnik, who was Notre Dame grad, and I got to meet Skip and get to know him. But then I really got to know him when he ran for mayor. We sat on the dais together. We had all sorts of talks about the vision of the city and he became a tremendous friend to me. He is truly a great mentor for me. He's a family man. He was a man of great faith, and a person I truly admired and respected. And there are so many people that feel that way in this city. And one of those people is John Walsh, who just retired as our chair of community redevelopment. And I'd like to bring this microphone down to John to say a few words of why the CRA wanted to dedicate 94th Avenue to Skip.
Thank you, John. I'm sitting down here because I got up this morning, but my back didn't get up with me. So, hello and once again, welcome to the special celebration of the legacy and work of such an honorable man as Walter Skip Campbell. I was proud to serve as the chair of the Community Redevelopment Agency for 8 years. During that time, I was fortunate to get to work with Mayor Skip Campbell. While I no longer serve as the chair of the CRA, I do want to take a moment to thank the past and current members for the support and of this initiative. The current members of the CRA, thank you all for coming up along with Skip's family today. Immediately following the sudden passing of our beloved mayor in October of 2018, the CRA Board of Directors met and unanimously made a motion to recommend the Coral Springs City Commission rename Northwest 94th Avenue Walter Skip Campbell Avenue in honor of his life and legacy and the service to Coral Springs. The City Commission also voted unanimously to do so. In 2019, the funding to replace all signposts with decorative posts and signage was approved. And by early 2020, installation was complete. What we did not know at that time, a global pandemic was headed our way during this important ceremony. But here we are today on St. Patrick's Day, which happens to be my dog's birthday. And he is wearing green. Seeing this initiative put forth by the CRA in the city of Coral Springs, is formally unveiled. To Lynn and the Campbell family, on behalf of the CRA, we thank you for sharing the time, talent, of your beloved Skip. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, John. John lost his voice a little bit because the Notre Dame game went to St. Patty's Day. 12:02 it ended, the Irish won on St. Patty's Day, so you know. John was so close to Skip, and I know you would ask him for advice all the time, and so thank you for those kind words. Now, please join me in welcoming Mayor Scott Brook, who would like to share a few words about Skip. Mayor.
Okay, yep. AJ. Okay. Thank you. Well, good morning. It's really an honor to be here with all of you. On behalf of my fellow commission and all of the staff from our city of Coral Springs, we're incredibly grateful to have you join us as we honor the life and legacy of my predecessor, my friend, my mentor, and our late mayor, Walter Skip Campbell. I want to thank all of our honored guests that are joining us this morning, but most importantly, I want to thank you, Lynn, and your entire family for the support, love, and courage, encouragement that you gave your husband, your uncle, your brother, whatever relationship you had with Mayor Campbell, Senator Campbell, to give back to so many of us in this community and across the state. Lynn, you are a rock for your husband. You are a foundation for what Skip could and did accomplish for our community. And on behalf of our community, Lynn, I want to say thank you for your support of your husband and our community. We can give Lynn a round of applause, please. Thank you. Like John, I want to recognize the CRA, including John, who not only brought forth the idea of renaming 94th Avenue after Skip, but they generously funded the signage. For myself and my fellow commission, the decision to dedicate 94th Avenue was simply a no-brainer. Skip's impact and his leadership to not only the city of Coral Springs, but to the entire state of Florida was, as a whole, unsurpassed. Skip was an iconic and distinguished attorney. He was a monumental warrior for justice in our community, our state, and our country. He was a dedicated public servant and a man of the people. He was a friend and mentor to many, and I think all of you would agree with me that Skip Campbell was the ultimate statesman. We miss him. This avenue serves as a gesture which will impact and remind citizens for generations to come of Skip's contributions to our community. I'm very grateful not only as a fellow attorney, but now as mayor once again of this fine city for Skip's mentorship, his vision, and his contributions. I have more than a few words, so please bear with me. I have a couple of personal things to share. So when I was running for city commission back in 2001, Senator Campbell at the time was one of the first mentors I reached out to. He didn't know me, but he gave me his time, gave me his wisdom, and he gave me his friendship. Later on, I'd visit him up in Tallahassee, in his office and at Clyde's, and we'd have people on both sides of the aisle talking, making a difference for our state in a respectful and statesman way. That's how Mayor Campbell led our community. He contributed a great deal to the public servant I am today. And as I'm listening to John Hearn speak of Mayor Campbell, I have served to emulate him in many ways, similar dedication to my faith and my family and to our community. Filling the seat of Mayor Campbell after his passing, his unfortunate passing, has been a blessing to me. It's something I don't take for granted. I'm grateful for. I have to let you know that for many days, the first year, year and a half, when I'd sit in my office after Mayor Campbell's passing, I'd have his picture in front of me in my office upstairs and just thank him and give him my gratitude for the man and leader that he was. And I'll forever be grateful. So this all brings us to today, St. Patrick's Day. Can you think of a better day than to honor a man like your husband, Lynn, than St. Patrick's Day? Oh, can't lose that. He loved his Irish heritage, and I'm just so grateful to have you all here today. Lynn, as you remember, we proclaimed Walter Skip Campbell Day on March 20th, 2020, but due to the pandemic, we had to privately share that proclamation. And now I'd like to read that proclamation. And so normally we wouldn't do this, but this is from the commission, so I'm gonna ask my commission to join me as well as Commissioner Vignola. So please come up here and we're gonna read the proclamation together. Commissioner Carter, Commissioner Sarah, Commissioner Vignola. Because this is us. And Mayor Campbell, Senator Campbell, was a representative of all of us. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for accepting my invitation. Walter Skip Campbell Day, March 17, 2020. Walter Skip Campbell was the beloved mayor of the city of Coral Springs from 2014 until his sudden passing in October of 2018. Mayor Campbell was tremendously proud of his Irish heritage. The naming of Skip Campbell Day on St. Patrick's Day is truly fitting for this incredibly gifted and gracious leader, friend, and family man. His leadership and spirit continues to inspire us each day and will continue to do so in the future. And on that note, we proclaim today Mayor Skip Campbell Day. Please let us have a round of applause in his honor. Thank you. Thank you all. So I'm about to call up John again. It's such a great with so many wonderful people. And I hope that you hold Mayor Campbell in your hearts today and lift him up in spirit on St. Patrick's Day. Before we unveil Walter Skip Campbell Day, I want to thank you all for being here. Now hand the mic over to our fabulous city attorney, John Hearn.
Thank you. Let's see if I got my stuff underneath there, right?
Yeah, I won't take it.
You're the best.
Thank you, Mayor. Man stealing my water, that could be trouble here. And thank you for your efforts in proclaiming March 17, 2020, Walter Skip Campbell Day. I know that was really special for the family. Next, I want to welcome longtime friend and partner of Skip's, Kelly Hancock, to provide his remarks. Kelly?
As John indicated, my name is Kelly Hancock, great law firm of Krupnik and Campbell. Can everyone hear me? Okay. I had the pleasure of practicing law and also going out almost every day lunch with Skip Campbell. He was one of my closest and dearest friends. And it's such a pleasure and an honor to speak on behalf of someone that we all loved, admired, and respected. The other day, I was trying to think, well, what should I say? What exactly should I say? And then it came to me that what would Skip say on today? What would he want all of you to know about today? What would, if he was up here speaking, what would he say to you? And what would he want you to remember about him? And we can all agree that Skip was one of the most generous, most kindness, and most compassionate person that we have ever known. You know, unlike Skip, most of us will never, ever have a street named after us. We will never have a courthouse. We will never have a golf tournament. So ask yourself, why was Skip so important? Why was he so special? Why was he so different? And why was he so unique? Was it his charm? Was it his intellect? Was it his wisdom? Was it his understanding? We know it wasn't his golf game, that's for sure. But then it came to me, and I know why now, and I'd like to share that with every one of you. It was because he cared. He actually cared. He made a difference, and that is why we are all here today. And that is why this street is being named after Skip Campbell. They say a life becomes more important when you have an impact on another person. And I think Skip had more impact on more people. And it doesn't matter how much money you have in the bank, doesn't matter how big your house is, doesn't matter how many cars you have, but what matters is what impact that you had on others. He was always here for all of us. He impacted all of us. He impacted this community, Coral Springs. And every day we have choices that we can make. We can make a choice to do something for ourselves, or we can make a choice to do something for others. Skip Campbell always chose to do something for others. And Lynn, as we said, you were the love of his life. You and your family were his greatest treasure. And you were blessed to have eternal love with him forever. And to the Campbell family, he loved you so much. You gave him so much joy and so much happiness. And so I, too, want to thank Lynn and the family. I want to thank all of you for sharing Skip Campbell with all of us. Thank you. So the first lesson that we can learn today, if Skip was speaking, is make an impact on others. It's too bad that we never realize how great someone is until they are gone. And it's too bad that we don't recognize how much we respect, admire, and love someone until they are gone. And we never realize how we are affected, such as this community, until they are gone. So, Skip would want all of us know to tell that special person how much you love them before they are gone. And I thought about the second thing that Skip would tell us today, and that is to stand up for justice. And when you see prejudice, stand up and be heard. When you see inequality, stand up and be heard. When you see racism and someone doing something wrong, stand up and be heard. Skip always stood up for the underprivileged, the disabled, the weak, the young, the elderly, the injured. He was always there to speak for them because they did not have a voice. So Skip would tell us today to stand up and be heard. And I will say that Skip died too young. He had much more to accomplish in his life. But does anyone know anyone that achieved or accomplished more than Skip did during his lifetime? As they say, it is not the years in life that matters. It's the life you put in years. Another way, it's not how long you live, but it's how you live that matters. And Skip lived life to the fullest. He really did. And time, we can't buy time. No one knows when we're going to be gone and it's going to be no longer here. And that's the third thing that I would tell you that Skip would want all of us to know. And that is to live for today and not wait until tomorrow. Life is so short, it's so precious, but it's so unpredictable. So whoever your loved one is, tell them how much you love them and how much you cared for them. My mother is almost 102 years old, and I truly love her. And she lives every day as if it will be her last, and soon it will be. But that doesn't stop her for living for today. And she knows that someday it'll be over, but she lives for today. So this is something that Skip would also want us to do, to live for today and don't worry about tomorrow because it may not come. In 10 years, 20 years, or 30 years, new people are going to move in to Coral Springs. And they will not know who Skip Campbell was. They will not know what Skip Campbell did, achieved, or accomplished. All they will know is that there's some street out there named Walter Skip Campbell. And they'll say, well, they'll wonder, who is this guy, Skip Campbell? Who is he? So today, I think we all have a certain responsibility, and that is to continue Skip's legacy. And not only in our hearts, but more important, in our deeds and our actions. So let's go out today and tomorrow and be like Skip Campbell. Let's make a difference and an impact on other lives. Let's stand up and be heard against injustice and inequality. And let's tell our loved ones how much we love them. And finally, let's live our life now and not wait until tomorrow. And that is what Skip Wood told us today. And that is what he would want us to know today if he was speaking. And when that curtain falls for us, and it will. It'll fall for all of us. Let's just make sure that we can say that we made a difference in other people's lives, just like Skip Campbell. Thank you.
Thank you, Kelly, for your reflection and kind remarks about our great friend, Skip. Skip was good at a lot of things, but Kelly's correct. He was not great at golf, yet he has God knows how many trophies in your house. The secret I can say now, unlimited mulligans. He was good with that. On behalf of Skip's wife, Lynn, and the entire Campbell family, I want to welcome up Dr. Maureen Campbell to give her thoughts and reflections.
Well, you're going to hear some common themes, and no, I did not know what anyone else was getting ready to say about Skip. So I guess the bottom line is that we all wrote our talks with a lot of love for Skip. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to share some memories of Skip. We came from humble beginnings. Our dad was a bartender, and our mom was a stay-at-home mom for six children. And although we did not have a lot of material things growing up, we never had a shortage of love and encouragement. Our parents always instilled in us that we were blessed. We had our faith in God, we had each other, and a family bond that could never be broken. They taught us the importance of giving ourselves to others who are less fortunate. Skip learned this lesson well. He was a true, loyal friend to so many. And although I probably don't need to tell you this, he had a passion for helping others. Skip was always fighting for those who couldn't fight for themselves. He thrived on looking out for the most vulnerable of our community, especially the youth and the elderly. My brother was a true champion for giving a voice to the voiceless. Doing all of this while never forgetting that this thing that we call life was much bigger than him, much bigger than all of us. For Skip, it was not about perfection, because none of us are perfect. We all have flaws. Flaws and all, Skip lived each day striving to be authentic and to be the best version of himself. I can speak for my entire family when I say that he made us proud every single day. Coral Springs was his home. Coral Springs was where he raised his family, coached soccer, t-ball, and baseball, and was a mentor to so many. He worked in downtown Fort Lauderdale, but chose to commute 45 minutes each way because he loved living in Coral Springs for nearly 45 years. Spending time with the youth and the leaders of tomorrow was immensely important to him. He loved participating every year in the Mayor's Chess Challenge, and every year was in awe of these young girls and boys who more often than not beat him at the game. He had a huge heart and loved to cheer them on. Skip was truly one of the good guys. A giant in both the political and legal professions. He was a natural leader who gave new meaning to the term advocate. When confronted with a situation, it was always about doing the right thing over any personal gain that he may have. Part of what made him a great leader was that he had the ability to foster collaboration and teamwork rather than divisiveness and petty bickering. During his time in the Senate, Skip was often tapped to be the consensus builder and a voice of reason, regardless of political affiliation. Republicans and Democrats alike knew that when they asked Skip for his counsel, he would give them his honest advice without partisan filters. He impacted so many lives as an attorney, as a state senator, and finally as the mayor of Coral Springs. He felt it was a great privilege to represent the citizens of Coral Springs as mayor, and he loved every minute of it. He was an honorable man who was kind, loving, and charitable. He was generous with his time and his devotion to his community. He lived life with integrity, accomplishing so much in his nearly 70 years. In writing this, I was reminded of a quote from the author Matthew Kelly. "The good we do never dies. It lives on forever, in other people, in other places, and in other times." Skip did a lot of good, more than we will ever fully know, and we believe that this good will live on. He was also a giant in our family, a loving husband, a devoted father, grandfather, brother, uncle, mentor, and friend. For our family, he was our go-to guy, our rock. No issue was too frightening or overwhelming because we knew that we had Skip in our corner. He had an unconditional love for each and every one of us, always available to cheer us on in the good times and pick us up in the bad times. His passing has left a huge void in the hearts and lives of all in our family. One of his greatest joys was spending time with his grandsons, Alex, Aaron, and Leo, especially taking them to play golf. He loved our family vacations, especially the trips to his cabin in Maine. He loved our Sunday family dinners at Kathleen and Bobby's home. An after-dinner highlight for him was when he would sit quietly in a chair and let our great niece Riley style his hair. He loved playing Candy Crush on his iPad. And interestingly enough, as engrossed in the game as it seemed to anyone looking on, he never missed an opportunity to chime into a discussion or a conversation going on in the room. He loved taking naps in his hammock in the backyard on a quiet Sunday afternoon, playing golf, maybe not so great, but playing golf, flying airplanes and helicopters. He was devoted to his Catholic faith and his church home at St. Elizabeth Ann Seton. He was proud to be a Florida Gator, and of course, for anyone who knew him, he was beyond proud of his Irish heritage. Celebrating St. Patrick's Day has been a top priority in our family since I can remember. He only missed it once when he was in the Senate and stuck in Tallahassee. He vowed to never let that happen again. Having this dedication on St. Patrick's Day makes it even more special for our family. This naming of the street in front of City Hall is an enormous honor, a forever memorialization to a great leader, a man who loved his city and gave it his all. He would have been extremely humbled and appreciative to all who made this a reality. On behalf of my sister-in-law, Lynn, their daughter, Christina, and her family, their son, Daniel, and my entire family, we would like to sincerely thank all who were instrumental in making this dedication a reality. Mayor Scott Brook, Commissioners Joy Carter, Larry Vignola, Joshua Simmons, Sean Serra, and former Commissioners Dan Daly and Lou Simaglia, John Walsh and the CRA, City Attorney John Hearn, the past City Manager Mike Goodrum, the current City Manager Frank Babinick, and Chief of Police Clyde Perry, along with the entire staff of the City of Coral Springs for honoring one of the good guys. Not just one of the good guys, but a great guy who loved working with every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Maureen. Skip truly was a kind and generous soul, and that is reflected in your family. When I see your family together, I see a great, wonderful family that he was a great, the rock of, but you guys together, beautiful, and it's great to see. I would like now to ask for Lynn and the immediate family to come on up to unveil Walter Skip Campbell Avenue. Please note there's going to be plenty of time for opportunities for additional photos. So for now, I'm going to ask if everyone could remain seated. We're going to unveil this. We're going to end the program briefly after that, and there's going to be plenty of time for pictures for everybody. So thank you. Your program says the Coral Springs Pipes and Drummers are playing When Irish Eyes Are Smiling. However, by tremendous demand, they're going to play 20 Men from Dublin Town. Thank you, Coral Springs Pipes and Drums. This concludes our ceremony. We are going to have some refreshments inside, and you can take photos. But I would like to leave you with an Irish blessing. May God give you for every storm a rainbow, for every tear a smile, for every care a promise, and a blessing in each trial. For every problem life sends, a faithful friend to share. For every sigh, a sweet song, and an answer for every prayer. Happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody.